don't believe it.
I do not believe it.
I don't believe it.
I don't believe it.
Well, that was Victor Meldrew and his catchphrase from One Foot in the Grave. Now, Thomas, or Doubting Thomas, one of the disciples, had a real problem with belief in the upper room after Jesus' resurrection. Reading from John chapter 20, verse 24. But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." And then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." And Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Thomas is one of my favourite characters in the New Testament. Every class needs a Thomas. We've all been there. A teacher explains a concept, but some don't understand. Not wanting to appear daft, we stay silent, except for the Thomas in the room, who asks for a second explanation. A sigh of relief all round as we cotton on without being singled out. Thanks, Thomas. Thomas's two questions in the New Testament actually produce two really important answers. The first I've just read. We're not told whether Thomas did or did not put his finger in the wound, but his reply was an emphatic, "My Lord and my God." No other disciple spoke with greater conviction. And it also teases from Jesus the compliment to all who try to believe without physical proof. The other significant appearance of Thomas was at the Last Supper. Reading from John chapter 14, verse 1. Jesus said, "I go and prepare a place for you, and will come again and will take you to myself. And you know the way to the place where I'm going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Without this question, Jesus would not have told us how we get to our heavenly home. Q&A, question and answer, always reveals, even when it's a planted question from a backbencher to the Prime Minister in the House of Commons. Here's how Bach set the text of the Creed, which starts, "I believe in one God," in his Mass in B minor.
Thank you.
It's definite and weighty. It leaves no room for doubt. You will believe, underlined. Few Christians I know believe everything they're told or read. Most have big questions they want answered, like Thomas. Christianity is about questions, not blind obedience. Schubert, when he set the same words from the creed as Bach, left out the clauses he didn't believe in, just didn't set them to music. A much more honest approach, you might say. And some people, in spite of huge efforts, just can't make their minds up, but still keep wrestling with the problems. Iris DeMent wrote a song called Let the Mystery Be. And it goes like this. Everybody's wondering what and where they all came from. Everybody's worrying about where they're going to go when the whole thing's done. But no one knows for certain, and so it's all the same to me. I think I'll just let the mystery be. Some say once you're gone forever, and some say you're going to come back. Some say you rest in the arms of the Saviour, if in sinful ways you lack. Some say that they're coming back in a garden, bunch of carrots and little sweet peas. I think I'll just let the mystery be. Some say they're going to a place called glory, and I ain't saying it ain't a fact. But I've heard that I'm on the road to purgatory. Horrible word, but it's an American song. On the road to purgatory, and I don't like the sound of that. Well, I believe in love, and I live my life accordingly. But I choose to let the mystery be.
Everybody is wondering what and where they all came from. Everybody is worrying about where they're gonna go when the whole thing's done. But no one knows for certain, and so it's all the same to me. Think out, yes, let the mystery be. Some say once you're gone, you're gone forever, and some say you're gonna come back. Some say you rest in the arms of the Savior if in sinful ways you lack. Some say that they're coming back in a garden, bunch of carrots and little sweet peas. Think out, yes, let the mystery be. Everybody is wondering what and where they all came from. Everybody is worried about where they're gonna go in the
keep asking questions, like Thomas, because through his questioning, we received two essential insights into the resurrection. And we may bring better understanding for those around us too timid to ask on their own account. Nor should we feel inadequate because we can't resolve some issues and have to leave them as mysteries. The Bible is full of examples where the writer doesn't fully understand what he's describing and resorts to linguistic fudges like, he ascended in a cloud. Bach set the words, I believe in God. Iris DeMent set the words, I believe in love. Pretty much the same thing in my book. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you taught us to love our neighbour and to care for those in need, as if we were caring for you. In this time of anxiety, give us strength to comfort the fearful and tend the sick, and to assure the isolated of our love and your love. For your name's sake, Amen. and we say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God the Father, by whose glory Christ was raised from the dead, strengthen us to walk with him in his risen life. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among us and remain with us always. Amen.
Mystery babe.